Today's video is sponsored by CuriosityStream. Hey you, and welcome. I'm Mr. Barry. In this whole video, we're going to be comparing Night Cafe's AI art generator with Blue Willow AI art generator. Now, for both of these, we're using the free version. I do know that there is a pro version in the Night Cafe, but I've never used it, never bought it. And all my creations have always been with the free version. So in the last video, we had one of my subscribers ask, how do you create images with Night Cafe for free without using credits? Well, it's rather easy. All you have to do is get in and create. And then once you're in the create page, notice if you go down the list, it'll ask you on the settings, number of images, choose one image. Now, if you do the default, which is 4 images, then that's going to cost 1 credit there. And so you click it to 1 image, it's 0 credits, and then the output resolution will be thumbnail, and then the runtime will be short. And then you click on create, and that's how you create images without having to use credits. So there you go, now you know how to create images for free in Night Cafe. For the Blue Willow, the same thing. We're not buying a subscription or anything like that. We're just using the basic free version for both. And then we're going to look at their features and see, is there a difference there in features, and can you actually do more with one than the other? All right, well, let's take a look at these AI art generators, you and I. Come on. Now I'm going to start by actually showing you some of the features and how to use Blue Willow. If you've used it already, go ahead and just skip to this stamp right here, this timestamp, and we'll see you there. So right when you go to bluewillow.ai, you'll notice they'll give you this invitation to join for the free beta. So we'll do that. Accept the invite. Okay, to get started creating with this AI art generator, all you have to do is go to one of the Worky channels that you see that I'm highlighting now. Be sure that you have verified your email, by the way, before starting your first image. Type /imagine and then a space, and after that the prompt box will appear. Describe the image you want. For example, cute cat sitting on a windowsill. In less than a minute, 4 images will appear. You can refine the images with the buttons. So you have the use that will enhance or upscale the single image that you've selected. The V will give you a new grid or variety based upon the image that you've selected. And then the refresh will give you a whole new set of 4 images based on your original prompt. To easily find your images in a busy activity stream, type mentions, colon, and then your username in the search box in the upper right hand corner there. Your images will appear below. Click Jump or Blue Willow to see the image in your stream. So I'm going to try Worky38. So one of the first things that you may notice is there are other users, and this is a stream, so there are many people already, and everyone is sharing their work there to the public. These are the prompts that they're using. And you can see which user's name there. So everything that you create will be seen here. So to start, let's go /imagine. And as soon as you have typed that, notice it says /imagine. Go ahead and click on that. And then we're gonna type in the prompt, which is very beautiful, firing blue, weird planet oiled by Alex Ross, 8K ultra detailed, dark atmosphere, cinematic lighting. And this is the AR, it means aspect ratio 3:2. And I kind of like that, so let's hit enter. And in a few minutes, it will display the image there with your prompt. Okay, here's the results. Now the U, that's for the upscale, and then the V is for variety. And then I can also refresh it. What I'm going to do is I like the very first one, so I'm going to upscale with the number 1. So I'm just going to click on that and upscale the very first image here. And there it is. It's quite beautiful. Let me click on it. And that is nice. I like it a lot. Now if I like another one of these, I can go in and say, well, I wish to upscale the second one here. So let's see how that works. There it is. Very nice. And another one that I like is this very fourth one. So let's go upscale number 4. There it is. So let's look at that. That is lovely. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go to Night Cafe and use the exact same prompt and see what it creates. So here we are in the create page for Night Cafe. On the text prompt, we can go here and I'm going to choose their exact same text as we had before. And now I'm not going to start with an image. I'm going to say one image, and you can actually do that and then just simply click on create 4 times to create your 4 images. So let's do that now. And here's the creation that it made. If I wanted to enhance it, I click on the enhance that could increase the size, but that does cost credits. If I want to evolve it and change things around, I can do that as well. Now what I'm going to do off screen there is actually click on that button where it says create 4 times and create 4 of those images. And then we're going to compare Night Cafe with the Blue Willow. And don't worry, I'm also going to try it out on Tilt Shift and a portrait. So for the following images, I'm just going to have the labels shown there so that you know which image came from which AI. And you can be the judge as far as which landscapes was done better. After the space landscapes, we're going to be looking at Tilt Shift, and then we'll be looking at portraits. Wow, so far they look pretty much neck and neck. The space landscapes looked pretty much like mirror images of each other. The tilt shift was very, very similar on either side there too. As far as the portraits, I think Night Cafe edged out just a little bit, but I think that was just the luck of the draw, because basically with each image, it uses a random model. And well, it was just the luck of the draw there, but they're very close on that one as well. What we're going to do now is actually look at the features. And I think this is where we're going to see Night Cafe pull ahead of Blue Willow. So we're going to start with looking at the features here in Night Cafe. On the creation page, you'll notice that I have the advanced mode turned off right now, so I can look at different options here with the algorithm. Notice that we have the stable, the DALL-E 2, coherent, we have artistic, as well as style transfer. So it gives me many different options there, so if I wanted something a different style, I could do that. Down here, we actually see the different styles. I can actually go in, and so if I wanted to have an image that was more of a photograph, I can actually choose that, and that way my image will be more of a realistic image. So notice I have many different styles here to choose from, and on all of these, by the way, I was using the same one, which was the default Night Cafe. Let me go now back to advanced mode, And that will turn this off here. If we go into here, you'll notice it says your text prompt. Click it. I can add as many text prompts as I need. I can also have negative prompts. I can change their weights. And it's easy to do, whereas if I was trying to do this in Blue Willow, I think it would be rather difficult to change the weight of each different prompt there. Next, we have a start image. So if I wanted to, I can click here and notice I have different start images. Now, if I wanted to find a new one, I just click right here where it says drag and drop an image or click here to upload it from my PC. But you notice I have a number of different images of my family and of the car, the family car, and other things there. So it's all here, and we can have a nice start image if I wanted to. Let's say that I actually did choose one of these, so I'll choose this one. And I'll click on Done. If I wanted to change something about the background, I could choose or create a mask. And so here's my mask, and I can then color in where I want that to be. Now, once I've colored in the mask, I can click on Done. And then I can go down here. I have other options to choose too. How many images do I want? 1, 4, 9, or even 16. I can change the output resolution from thumbnail, low res, or medium res. I can do a runtime, short, medium, long. And I could even change the aspect ratios if I needed to. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do medium runtime on this just to see what it's going to be like with that prompt of a tiny village behind us to see what happens. Okay, it made a beautiful image there. So behind us, it looks kind of like a forest with a village, maybe some buildings in there as well. Pretty awesome. So as you can see, there are many, many different options here. We can even change the seed number. So I'm going to do a random seed. And this time I'm going to do a short runtime just to see if it does something different. And you can see the result is a little bit different there, but still really nice. And that was a free generation. Okay, other features that we have in Night Cafe, if I go to My Creations, I can actually see all the work that I've created. And we can also separate our work into different categories called collections. So I can go in and just click on one of these, and you can see all the work that I created with that topic. Going back to my collections there. So we have many different ones there. Here's dogs. So as far as I know, we cannot put our work that we created in Blue Willow into these little tiny folders. And so more features, the better, and that's what we find there in Night Cafe. Other things that we can do too is we can explore. And when we explore other people's work, we can actually see different types of work based on the tag that's on them. So if I just wanted to see landscapes, or if I just wanted to see fantasy, I could just click on those, landscape for example, and just see landscapes. There we go, so we'll just see landscapes. So I can really filter my work that I'm looking for, which is awesome. The other thing that's really nice is you have these challenges. And so every day you actually gain points or credits simply by voting for who's the best. So you get free credits. And if you click here, you'll notice, hey, look at this. I received 5 free credits because my image that I entered into the challenge won. Yay! And I'm here today, so automatically you get 5 credits. So this is the image that won. And it's really cute there. I can actually show you the collection for that, because I actually made a lot of those. This is called Strange Creatures, and these are the strange creatures I made using lots of text prompts. And these were the text prompts. So notice here I have 12 different prompts, and I used many different ones there to create this dynamic scene. Believe it or not, but all these use the exact same prompt. So all of these have the same prompt used over and over again, but different seeds. And this is the image that won. Okay, now we're in the Blue Willow AI creator there. And I see other people's work and I see their prompts, so they can't hide their prompts. And you can hide your prompts in the Night Cafe. But just going around and just finding particular ones, like if I just wanted to find landscapes, well, there's no real way to do that as far as I know. Also, when I'm creating one, I'm limited to just creating my prompt as seen here. So if I said, you know, red car climbing a mountain, I'm limited as far as if I wanted to mask something. So if I didn't want this cave in here, in the Night Cafe, I could mask this over and then just type in prompt sky and it'll put a sky up here and take away this cave effect. So it's all up to you on which one you want to use. I believe that Night Cafe won in the features category, hands down. I'm able to do more with it and they're both free. So I would go with Night Cafe as far as if I was really serious and wanting to create detailed work that I use in my YouTube channel. Hey, do you love learning about astronomy, science, and maybe other topics? I recommend CuriosityStream. You can actually find the CuriosityStream link down in the description, but you can learn about all these types of topics, and they have wonderful documentaries. In fact, they have thousands of documentaries on there, such as this one, Destination Moon. Now, let's say space is not your thing. Perhaps you want another topic such as food or clothing or history. They have it all right here at CuriosityStream. And one of the nice things is you can actually stream this on your different devices. Curious about artificial intelligence? Well, they have many different documentaries on the subject. In fact, I had AI create a play, all of the accompanying artwork, and it even did the acting and voiceovers. You can see it for free right now with the link that I have at the top of the screen. So CuriosityStream is awesome if you are into learning like I am. So which AI art creator do you like most? Is it the Night Cafe with all the extra features that you have in there, or is it the Blue Willow? Hey, it's your choice. Go ahead and add it down there to the comments and as far as which one you like most. And we'll see which one wins there. It's been a lot of fun making this video. I really do enjoy working with AI and allowing it to make this wonderful art with the text prompts. I think AI is just really coming along great there, and being able to use it to make something so amazing is absolutely wonderful. Hey, if you like these types of videos, please give it a thumbs up, comment down below, because I do read your comments. If you have an idea for a future video, put that down there as well. And a big thank you to all those who are sharing my videos across the world there. And if you haven't done so already, I hope you do subscribe to my channel. All right. Hey, y'all have a very good day and see you next time. Bye-bye.